Okay, you fans of the great James Dean all over the world, and you fans of popular culture of the 20th century, I'm in the Hollywood Hills, and I'm gonna take you to where James Dean took that famous photograph of him playing the bongos by a photographer named Frank Worth, and I'm gonna take you to exactly the spot where he was backing out his 1500cc super speedster Porsche. And thankfully, it's still there, the spot where he's backing out. And those three windows that you see in the background, they're a little bit blocked by this hedge right here. And it's at 1541 Sunset Plaza Drive, where he lived on top of this garage from January 1955 to July of 1955, until he moved out to Sherman Oaks into the log cabin that he rented from his friend Nico Romanos, who was the maitre d' at Via Capri, one of his favorite restaurants. And here you go, you fans, right here. This is where he was pulling out in his white Porsche Super Speedster right here. And here's the address, 1541 Sunset Plaza Drive. And thankfully, it's still extant for you fans. And I was trying to look for a photo of him walking out of the side there, down those stairs, and I couldn't find it, but that photo was taken by Frank Worth, the photographer, and he also, this is where he lived when he went to Fairmont to do that photo essay with Dennis Stock. And the reason why he moved here is because, first of all, he met a guy named Rogers Brackett in 1951, who had an apartment down this street near Sunset. And then when he came back, I guess he was familiar with this area, and he liked these switchbacks that you see. And he used to drive his, there's a lot of stories about him coming off these really tight switchbacks right here, that if you're a big fan, you'll know about all those little goings on up and down where he'd drive at a real acute angle. And so he moved here because he was kicked off the lot by Jack Warner. He was living in his dressing room, and when Jack Warner found out, he said, "Get that little bastard off the lot." And this is where he moved to, January of 1955, and he was still waiting for East of Eden to be released, which was released that April of 1955. And then he started filming Rebel Without a Cause while he lived here in March to May. And then after that was wrapped, then he met, right before he left to Marfa, Texas, June 3rd, he met Ursula Andress at the Pink Palace on Sunset, which was owned by Jane Mansfield, which incidentally, I think Engelbert Humperdinck bought that house. Anyway, He met Ursula Andress, and then he took off on the train to Marfa to film Giant in Texas. And then he came back July 17th, and then, like I said, he moved out. He got a one-year lease at the log cabin in Sherman Oaks, where, if you're at all interested, I've got a lot of James Dean videos where he's lived in L.A. here, and where he hung out. And this, when he was living here, this is where he met a one-legged jazz singer named Toni Lee Scott. I don't know if she was a singer at the time, but he met her at Googie's. And there's a famous photo. She's got blonde hair, and they're right in front of Googie's. And I recognize the street, and I recognize the stores right across from it, but you can only see her back. And she had one leg. She lost it in a motorcycle accident, And I guess because of Jimmy, he encouraged her, and that's when she became a jazz singer. And then he was dating a little Swedish actress named Lily Cardell here. And then Dana Winter of Invasion of the Body Snatchers fame, he was dating her a little bit. And when he came back that July 17th, and he moved to Sutton Street in Sherman Oaks, that's when he started dating pretty regularly Ursula Andress. And then she left him right before he died for John Derek, the actor. And like I said, this is where he lived when he for the Life photographer, the Life magazine photographer, Dennis Stock. This is where he left to go to New York, take those famous photographs. I think that famous one where he's got the overcoat on Broadway, it's called The Street of Dreams. Anyway, he left here to go to New York, and then he went to Fairmont before he died, and he took all those photos where he grew up with Dennis Stock. And let's get a little zoom in there. But thankfully, this significant part of Jimmy, this is where he lived. All the significant parts of his life where fame exploded on the screen for him here when East of Eden was released. And then very significant happenings in this house. In fact, he was an inveterate. He couldn't sleep. He was an insomniac. So he used to hang out with this group of young people called the Night Watch. And one of them was Myla Nurmi. They used to call her Vampira. She had a show on Saturday night showing horror films. She was, you could almost say she was the first goth. And then he was hanging out with this guy named John Gilmore. He met him in New York. And another guy named Leonard Rosenman. He's the guy that scored his first two films. He met him in New York. He was hanging out here with Jack Simmons, who played Cookie and Rebel Without a Cause. And he was also, Nick Adams was part of the Night Watch. I guess they were all insomniacs, as they'd be sitting at Googie's all night drinking coffee. And he hung out with Keenan Wynn. He was part of the Night Watch. And another guy named Arthur Lowe Jr. He was the grandson of Adolf Zukor, the founder of Paramount. And his other grandfather was Arthur Lowe, who founded MGM. So this is where he hung out with those guys. And Perry Lopez, this other Puerto Rican young actor from New York, he was signed to Warner Brothers around January of 1955. So he hung out with them here. There's a lot of photographs of him in here playing the bongos and listening to records. And Perry Lopez, because he grew up on the rough streets of New York, Jimmy was using him and to kind of like teach him how to act like a juvenile delinquent a la New York streets, I guess Brooklyn, for the upcoming Rebel Without a Cause. And so Perry Lopez, who he went on actually to become Lieutenant Escobar in a film called Chinatown with Jack Nicholson in 1974. So if you've read a lot of biographies like Shelley Winters, Dennis Hopper, they always talk about him riding his Triumph here. And when he moved in here, he still had his red MG that he bought when he first got the money from signing for East of Eden. And this is where he traded in that MG for that 1500cc Super Speedster Porsche. And man, I'm so glad it's still here for you fans, you hardcore fans like me. And you can get a little shot of those three windows right there behind that hedge right there. And then when he moved to Sherman Oaks, he traded in that super speedster for his 550 Spyder, which, as we all know, he got killed in September 30th, 1955, to race on October 1st. So this is that speedster where you see him backing out in this driveway right here. This is the car that he drove at the Palm Spring races and the Santa Barbara races right before Rebel Without a Cause started filming. And then he didn't start racing again until September 21st. Well, actually, when he started driving his Porsche, when he came back, when when giant wrapped. So here you go, where the great James Dean once hung out and lived his life. So Jimmy, wherever you're at, good night, sweet prince.